Welcome to the Bryan Collegiate High School commencement exercises for the class of 2018. Before we begin, I want to remind you that this is a very special day for all of our graduates and their families. So we want to make sure we honor this day appropriately. Please silence your cell phones and please be courteous and do not use air horns or anything of the like during the ceremony. I appreciate your courtesy and respect for this once-in-a-lifetime occasion for our graduates. Additionally, I would also like to share that the content and views of the expressed during the ceremony is solely and entirely the private expression of the individual and does not reflect the endorsement, sponsorship, position of the district.
Please rise as the Bryan High School Junior ROTC post the colors.
Thank you. stripes and bright stars, through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Now please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge of allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please remain standing for the invocation. Please join with me in prayer. Father, thank you so much for our time here together tonight, for all the friendship we have made throughout the years, for all the days of laughter and fun we have shared, for all the times of great discovery and learning we have encountered, and for all the trials we have faced and come out triumphant in the end. Father, we are grateful for all you have given, who have given their time, energy, and skill so that we could graduate tonight. Thankful for all the family members, teachers, and mentors you have placed in our lives who have supported us through the years. May you bless them in the years to come. As we begin to write a new chapter in our lives, we pray for strength, pushing us on in perseverance and the drive to never give up. For faith, reminding us to always follow our dreams, no matter how impossible they may seem. And for hope, giving us a reason to continually look forward to what tomorrow will bring. Thank you for our time together tonight and for all that we have to look forward to. It is in your name we pray, amen. You may now be seated. Please join me in welcoming our principal, Mr. Tommy Roberts.
Good evening. On behalf of the Board of Trustees of the Bryan Independent School District, our administration, faculty, and staff, and on behalf of the students and soon-to-be graduates, it is my honor and privilege to welcome you to the Class of 2018 commencement ceremony for Bryan Collegiate High School. I'm Tommy Roberts, and I've had the privilege of serving as the principal at Bryan Collegiate this year. Graduates, I have watched all of you grow into mature young adults, and I am so proud of all that you have accomplished. Tonight is the representation of your accomplishments. You have earned a combined total of over 4,200 college credit hours, with an average of 52 college credit hours each. Between all of you, you have earned well over 205 college acceptances and over $1.9 million of grants and scholarships. You have also served in our local community over 15,000 hours of community service. 57 of you are the first to go to college in your families, and some of you are even the first to graduate high school. Congratulations on these amazing feats. Mm-hmm. I will begin with the introduction of our guests on stage tonight. Please hold your applause until we are done with all introductions. Please stand when I call your name. Dr. Christy Whitbeck, Superintendent of Bryan ISD Schools. Mark McCall, Board President. Mr. William Trey Moore III, Board Vice President. Mrs. Felicia Boxley, Board Secretary. Mr. David Stasny, Board Member. Dr. Douglas Warnerberger, Board Member. Mrs. Ruthie Waller, Board Member. And Dr. Julie Harlan, Board Member. Dr. Desiree Caperton, Bryan Collegiate High School Associate Principal. Mrs. Amy Caesar, our keynote speaker for the evening. Mrs. Sheila Holmeyer, Bryan Collegiate Academic Advisor. Mrs. Christina Richardson, Executive Director of Advanced Academics, Bryan ISD. Dr. Jimmy Bird, Executive Dean of the Blinn Campus in Bryan. Mrs. Ginger Carabine, Chief of Staff, Bryan ISD. Dr. Barbara Yubara, Associate Superintendent of Teaching and Learning, Bryan ISD. Mr. Kevin Bisall, Assistant Superintendent of Business Services, Bryan ISD. Seth Ring, Senior Class President. Mrs. Dana Bichuk, Name Announcer. Mrs. Lucy Villarreal, Bryan Collegiate Registrar. Jesus Ortiz, Class Representative, Senior Class Representative. Destiny Harris, Senior Class Representative. Henry Bedeker, Senior Class Representative and Class Valedictorian. Alexis Vasquez, Senior Class Representative. Micah Smith, Senior Class Representative. Cassandra Flores, Senior Class Representative. Antonia Renfro, Senior Class Representative. Finally, I would also like to recognize a group of world-class educators that chose each and every day to do what's right by kids and what's best for kids. If you are a current or former staff member of Bryan Collegiate High School, please stand and be recognized for your unwavering commitment in helping these seniors achieve what they have been working towards for the past 4 years. Now help me in welcoming the senior class president, Mr. Seth Ring.
Good evening, everyone. I'd like to welcome you to the graduation ceremony for Bryan Collegiate's class of 2018. This is an important night for us students and is a big step towards our future. However, when I look out into this crowd, I see hundreds of faces, but the 2018 class only has 80 students graduating tonight. This shows how many people are here supporting their son, daughter, family, or friend. And to you, I would like to extend a huge thanks, because I know you guys have done much more than just show up to this ceremony. You have driven us, you've bought us school supplies for us, encouraged us, and so much more on countless days and nights over the past 4 years. Me and my fellow classmates would not have made it this far without your constant support throughout our high school experience. So sincerely, thank you guys. Now, while we are talking about support, it would be really unfair to not mention Bryan Collegiate's teachers and staff. These people are some of the best in the business, and this school would not work if they weren't all so amazing at their jobs. Every single member of the faculty here, you can tell they have a passion and belief for education. They all go the extra mile every time and go above and beyond their job descriptions in order to make this school a great place to learn. And I would like to give a special thanks to two members of the staff, Mr. Roberts and Dr. Caperton. We cannot ask for better leaders for this school, and they both did an excellent job their first year in their new positions. Additionally, we have to show our appreciation for Mrs. Richardson. She created this school all those years ago, and her and the faculty here at Bryan Collegiate are truly making a generation of students that not only are making it to a higher education, but they are excited to do so. Now finally, I'd like to congratulate you, my fellow classmates. This is it, we are really close. After today, we'll all go our separate ways. But we are always a really tight class. I have known and been close to all of you at one point or another over the past 4 years. So let's not make today a goodbye. Let's make this a see you later. I believe that we can and will stay close over these years. We have always had each other's backs from Blinn to volunteer service. And that shouldn't end just because we're going our separate ways and we're going to be far apart. So I really hope all of you keep in touch and that everyone will show up to our class reunion. Now, will the top 10% please make your way to the stage?
On behalf of the senior class of 2018, on this date, May 25th, we are presenting the school and the student body with a set of family flags.
This unique gift will become a great way for the BCHS community to honor every family. This set of flags will be installed in each classroom and can be removed to be placed at family events and pep rallies.
We are delighted to accept this class gift on behalf of the students and staff of Bryan Collegiate High School. We wish the senior class of 2018 the best of luck in your future endeavors.
You have left us with many great memories that we will treasure forever in our hearts. Congratulations on your accomplishments, and thank you for this gift that we will which will be used probably by our fellow Panthers for many years to come.
Congratulations, graduates, for all that you've accomplished during the last 4 years. I'm so very proud of each and every one of you. At this time, we will recognize those students who are the class of 2018 honor graduates. The class of 2018 honor graduates are Samantha Hunt. Samantha will attend the United States Merchant Marine Academy this fall with a 4.7731 grade point average. Skylar Tadero. Skylar will attend Southern Methodist University this fall with a 4.78 grade point average. Zachary Cantu. Zachary will attend Texas A&M University this fall with a 4.8035 grade point average. Jesus Ortiz. Jesus will attend Texas A&M Corpus Christi at the Rellis campus this fall with a 4.8088 grade point average. Lisa Dillard. Lisa will attend the University of Texas at Austin this fall with a 4.8644 grade point average. Jasmine Dillard. Jasmine will attend the University of Texas at Austin this fall with a 4.9509 grade point average. The class of 2018 salutatorian, Destiny Harris. Destiny will attend the University of Texas at Austin this fall with a 5.0475 grade point average. And the class of 2018 valedictorian is Henry Bedeker. Henry will attend the University of Texas at Austin this fall with a 5.2714 grade point average.
Hi, Mom. Oh, hi, Dad. Now, I was told to make this speech represent the class of 2018. No, that does not mean I made it this morning. However, it does mean I believe I speak for all of us when I thank the amazing faculty and staff of Bryan Collegiate. The teachers at Bryan Collegiate are truly amazing. I would also like to extend thanks to our parents and relatives who helped us along the way, and many of whom are here tonight. I would also like to thank most of our BLIN professors. Not to state the obvious, but just 4 years ago, we were 4 years younger. But you know, somehow it doesn't feel like 4 years. It's been a long journey, and so many things have happened that it's hard to believe it's just been 4 years. At the same time, it feels like it's been much less than 4 years. If you didn't focus for a second, high school passed by in a flash. Here we are, already at graduation, ready to move on in our lives. However, every last one of us cannot be sure of what the future will hold. In this way, class of 2018, I know many of you are scared. Scared that our future won't live up to our hopes and expectations. Scared that our plans will fall through and we will find ourselves on a completely different path. Scared that we will trip on the graduation stage. We are terrified by our uncertain future. But you know what? We've come too far to be scared now. These past 4 years haven't been all roses. There have been many thorn bushes here and there, and now here we are at a grand fork in the trail of life, where we will continue on our individual journeys. Let me remind you how far we've come. Back in freshman and sophomore year, we didn't know a lot of things, like how hard our collegiate English classes would be, or that giraffes sleep only 20 minutes every day. Okay, many of you didn't know that until now, but. Junior year, we took our first steps onto BLIN campus and frantically searched for to-be verbs in our essays. Finally, in our last year at Collegiate, senior year, we found ourselves making one of the biggest decisions of our lives, where we would go to college. We didn't know how far we'd come, and many of us didn't know if we would make it to this very graduation ceremony. But all 80 of us made it, and nothing could change that. Now, we all have some amazing memories from high school. We've had many highs and lows. So many things have happened in these past 4 years, much of which none of us could predict. We will always look back on high school with fondness, but make sure to look towards the future with even greater ambition. We're heading out into the real world very soon, and it's easy to get caught up in your past high school life. It's easy to worry that the future may not bring what you hope it will. However, remember, your true glory days are yet to come. Let the past guide your future. We have overcome many struggles in our lives in these past 4 years. I believe that we are stronger because of them. Let your past experiences assist your decisions in the future. Remember that our futures will be long. They will have rough patches here and there, but I believe our futures shine even brighter than our past. The step in our lives is a big one, but it leads towards our future, a future in which we will succeed. Now, we will never forget our days at BLIN together, or those English classes. And let us not forget Dave Ramsey, or Miss Carrion, making a 10-minute video, or a 2-minute video into 10. We'll never forget any of it. But remember that this is the time to move on, to make more memories, to take the next step in our lives. Our glory days will not remain in high school. Let us make our futures great. Once again, class of 2018, I congratulate you. And let's make our class reunion a Lamborghini party.
Freshman year feels like it was forever ago now. As we look back, a lot has changed in 4 years. Go back and try to remember how you felt. As we came in and heard from upperclassmen and teachers alike about collegiate culture and how we would become a family, we were always warned about the procrastination, even though we still learned for ourselves instead of taking the advice. This was also the year how spirited, or not spirited, we are at pep rallies became evident. Freshman year was the year that we first started discovering each other and ourselves. We had to choose to step out of our comfort zones and meet new people who would become the friends that we have today. We had to learn how to transform from middle schoolers to high schoolers and semi-college students all at the same time. Most of all, I feel like freshman year was a big year of oh no moments. You know, those moments when you're like, oh no, what did I get myself into? This began pretty early on for me. My first day of freshman year, I came and got my schedule, figured out how to read it after staring at it for a while, and went to my first class, thinking, it's the first day. We'll just talk about the syllabus or something. I soon found out I was wrong when Ms. Gase taught a whole lesson of algebra after briefly introducing herself and then assigned homework. I feel like freshman year was like that for most of us in one way or another. From that moment on, I knew collegiate would be difficult, but it slowly became evident how worth it would be.
Going into sophomore year was pretty interesting. We all thought we were cool since we were now taking blend classes such as sociology, anthropology, art, and music appreciation. Assignments began to hit us like crazy, whether it was a sociology assignment quiz or a music concert report from Professor Lawrence. But these classes were not necessarily the highlight of sophomore year for me. Sophomore year was one of the most memorable years, mainly because of one teacher. Yeah, you guessed it, Ms. Zachary. This was her first year, and she came in ready to work with each one of us individually in order to make us successful. I remember when we all learned how to write an SAR, and she would repeat, state the prompt, answer the prompt, quote, explain, over and over again. Ms. Zachary made a huge mark in my life that year, and I know I will never forget that. We also can't forget about those world history notes in Ms. Schrader's class. I know we all got tired of doing those summaries on sticky notes for every page, and I know Ms. Schrader got tired of sending half of every class period to ICU. Although we complained about all the work from Ms. Zachary and Ms. Schrader, I honestly feel like they did a magnificent job on preparing us for the following years.
Looking back on junior year, it was one of the most difficult years for our class, or for most. It was a year filled with hard work, motivation, and maybe some heart problems. Junior year was a year that we were pushed beyond our limit. It was a memorable milestone because we had finally made it halfway through high school. That year, we were having to deal with our first time being on the Blinn campus for classes. It was a different experience and a scary one because we were so used to having each other in every single one of our classes. But then at Blinn, we went to having maybe one or two other classmates, or maybe none for some of us. We had to learn to make new friends, to work together, and to succeed in those classes. While we had to deal with this obstacle at Blinn, there were countless more to be dealt with at Collegiate. That year, we had Mr. Persine's class, where we had the choice to have the tenacity and learn the material on our own. We also had Ms. Nichols and Ms. Lavinka for physics. This subject for most of us was one of the hardest, although they both tried to make it entertaining. We also had Mr. Kinsner with endless essays, where we always had enough time for, but were always done last minute. Those habits still haven't changed up to this point. Lastly, we had Ms. Bichuk with what seemed endless prep for ACT and SAT, including the most important project of the year, our junior service project. Junior year will be one of the most important years I remember from high school, because it was the year that I finally came out of my shell and the year that I met the girls that had become the most important in my life. But overall, I feel like that year was when everybody decided to be a bit more outgoing and interact more with other friend groups. I'm so grateful for that because of that, it was what got us through our junior year and encouraged others to finish strong until the end. And that led us to the best year of them all, senior year.
And now a reminiscence about our senior year. Between senior class pictures, ordering our graduation caps and gowns, applying to scholarship after scholarship, stressing over exams, and the worst struggle, senioritis. So now we're finally here. You only go to high school once, so we all went to our last high school dances like homecoming and prom, which were all pretty lit with Henry's wild and interesting dance moves and Destiny popping and locking out on the dance floor to our last soccer games where we can hear Jesus screaming his lungs out and slowly losing his voice. And we can't forget the stress we put on Mr. Roberts getting into his new position as principal this year. Also, those semester projects some of us had for government, which we obviously did last minute, especially those 2,000-word research essays for English, LOL. And let's not forget Ms. Carrion showing us those endless videos of Dave Ramsey. In high school, we've all studied, volunteered, and participated in extracurricular activities. So overall, don't do an activity for the sole purpose of putting it on a resume as we go into different colleges. Don't do an activity because you think it will impress other colleges as well. Do it because you want to do it, because you are passionate about it, and because it will enrich you. High school was neither a high nor a low point in our lives. It was like what I like to call a medium point. If it was a high point for you, great. However, it should never be the highest point. As our senior year comes to an end, there is a world, a magnificent but scary world, beyond the walls of high school that is waiting for you. I, along with all the other graduating seniors, will have a chance to turn those maybes into realities during college and beyond. These past 4 years at Bryan Collegiate have been quite a roller coaster ride, and I wish you all to never give up on your dreams as we start this new journey in our lives after today. Thank you.
I have the pleasure of introducing our keynote speaker for the evening. She is a great educator and was a respected member of our faculty at Bryan Collegiate for several years. She now works as a school counselor at Upper Darby High School in Drexel Hill, Pennsylvania. We requested that she speak tonight since she has been such a significant part of your journey at Bryan Collegiate High School, and she's graciously agreed to come back home for tonight to speak to you guys. Please welcome Mrs. Amy Caesar.
I can't promise there won't be tears. So, if you don't mind, I'd like to take the first few minutes to specifically speak to the 80 graduates sitting in front of me. I know that if I want them to remember what I'm going to say, they need to hear it right now, because as these minutes tick by, they will eventually tune me out. So, surprise! I know it's tradition that the graduating class requests who gives the keynote address. So I hope the surprise of having it be me is a welcomed one. I have to say, it was getting hard ignoring the Facebook messages asking me if I was coming. I'm sorry if I didn't respond. I was trying to surprise you. Sorry if I lied to you in the lobby. I was trying to surprise you. So, it's hard for me to believe that this night is finally here, the day that you've all been longing for. In less than 30 minutes, you're going to be Bryan Collegiate graduates. This is something to be proud of. You've worked so hard for this, and I know most of you are so happy it's over. But please don't pause here too long. Take a moment, enjoy yourself, enjoy the celebration, and then set that next goal, and for old time's sake, make it a smart one. But really, I want you to know that I'm so incredibly proud of each and every one of you. You're the first graduating class that has a 100% acceptance rate to a four-year university. That's impressive, and I'm not surprised. I'm truly not surprised. You guys have all been rather special the entire time I've known you. So now back to the official stuff. Okay. To say that I'm humbled to be speaking to you this evening is an understatement. When I was asked a few months ago to be the keynote speaker for graduation, I didn't hesitate to accept. You see, when I moved to Philadelphia last summer, I promised these kids that I'd be back for graduation. And I really tried to keep that promise. I mean, how could I not be here? I've had every single one of these 80 graduates in class, either their 9th, 10th, or 11th grade year, and some just in ICU. So being here tonight to see them graduate will surely be one of my life's fondest memories. In addition to making the trip back to Texas, also gave me a great excuse to reconnect with some faculty members that have become very close friends. And to eat some authentic Mexican food, because they don't have a lot of that in Philly. So by now you've figured out that I'm not from around these parts. I'm originally from Michigan, born and raised. So when I moved here in 2014, I was lucky enough that the administration of Bryan Collegiate took a chance on this Yankee. Thank you. I was hired to teach PCC, For those of you who don't know what PCC is, it's a support class to help kids navigate the uniqueness of collegiate and help them get skills to just be successful in high school and beyond. The irony is that I was not wildly successful in high school, and they all know that, I've told them. And I really had no direction after graduation. I knew I was supposed to do something, so I found myself going to community college, taking a class here or there, and working full time. I know I wasn't really happy, and I wasn't doing what I was supposed to be doing, but I was hoping that something or somebody would come along someday and show me that path. So in February of 1994, that something came along. My roommate asked me for a ride to an interview at a temp agency. I obliged and found myself perusing the brochures in the lobby, because who wants to sit in a car in Michigan in February? For some reason, I found myself drawn to the military brochures, and 2 days later was sitting in the Army office taking the ASVAB. I didn't have a lot of background knowledge about the military, except that my father had served for 4 years in the Army, so that's where I started. They wanted me to sign on the dotted line that day, and I wasn't really ready, wanted to talk to my parents, so I decided that I would get up and just leave. But I made one last stop to the Navy office. I was greeted with a hearty, what can I do for you, shipmate? And that greeting definitely got my attention, so I walked in and I met ET-1 Wheeler, who would eventually become my recruiter. I remember making sure that he knew I was 21 years old, I wasn't just some teenager, so I would appreciate the truth. He obviously shared enough with me, because 2 months later I found myself on a plane to boot camp. I didn't know really what my future held at that point. I took a leap of faith and I committed to it. Graduates, you too are going to find times in your life where you don't know what's around the corner. Don't let those times stop your journey. Take the time to make the best decision you can and keep going. I learned many lessons in boot camp, but I can say in general that the military shaped who I am today. Much of the knowledge that I tried to impart on these 80 graduates came from what I learned during my military service, as well as my life's journey. I spent 7 years on active duty as a dental technician and was often pushed to what I thought were my limits. I pushed beyond those preconceived limits many times because I chose to live a life with no excuses. I always had felt like I had a slight disadvantage joining the military at age 21. Physically and career-wise, I just sort of felt behind. But with every new duty station, I pushed myself. The most challenging being my last when I was stationed with the Marine Corps. Prior to reporting for duty, I spent 7 weeks of training called Field Medical Service School, where I would learn how to be a medic in times of war. The physical requirement was that of like Marine Corps boot camp, up at 4 a.m., running 5+ miles a day, PTing twice a day. We also attended classes that taught us preparing us for wartime emergencies. The training culminated with a 12-mile hike into what they called the bush, or the field. We carried 100-pound packs on our back. We stayed for 1 week in 2-man tents with no bathroom or shower facilities. During the day, we practiced navigation and wartime tactics, and at night, we practiced search and rescue missions. We slept less than 4 hours a night, but nothing less than our best was expected. No excuses. When the week came to an end, there was one way back, on our feet, that same 12 miles, with that same 100-pound pack on our back, except the night before it had downpoured and it was exponentially heavier on the way back. But no excuses. If you couldn't make the hike back, you didn't graduate and had to repeat the 12 weeks. So no excuses. On the hike out, I had suffered an injury that had had no time to heal, but I was determined to make it back to base. No excuses. I'll never forget the smell of Burger King, which still is my favorite fast food restaurant, on base as we hiked that last mile. Everything hurt. My blisters had blisters. I needed a shower, and I'm sure there were tears. But I was accomplishing something that not many people do, especially women, and no excuses. Graduates, I guarantee you too will find yourself in situations that seem impossible to navigate. But you'll find a way, because that's who you are. You are a find-a-way, make-a-way group, and it's evident because you're sitting here tonight. I spent my last 3.5 years of active duty stationed in Hawaii. I know, pretty bad. I decided that after my time in the Navy, I wanted to be a history teacher. So finally, at age 28, I'd figured out what I wanted to be when I grew up. I refused to leave the Navy without a degree, and I had 3.5 years to accomplish that goal. I spoke with one of the universities that offered classes on base and off and mapped out a plan. Honestly, it left no room for a social life, but I had a deadline, so no excuses. My schedule was tight. I even had to work around a deployment, but no excuses. I was up at 4 a.m. for PT, I worked all day, and I went to class every single night. But no excuses. I spent the weekends in class or doing homework. No excuses. Something that I often said to these 80 graduates when doing grade conferences or when they were up against a deadline and stressed was what I had to say to myself during those 3 years, and that's short-term sacrifice, long-term gain. I actually ended up finishing 5 months early, and I think I spent most of those 5 months on the beach when I wasn't working. There are several other times in my life that the no excuses mentality has helped me when circumstances have seemed impossible. But I know these kids are anxious to get their diplomas, so I'll close with this. Graduates, know this for certain. There are going to be times that you are going to have to give up something in order to get something. Just remember, no excuses. You're going to have days when you feel like you're barely hanging on, and it's okay. That's normal. Dig deep and keep pushing. No excuses. And like I've told you a million times before, when you find it impossible to believe in yourself, just use my belief in you to power through. 4 years ago, when you were all just names on a class list, I already believed in you. And 4 years later, I still believe in you, and those names that were on the class list will always be in my heart. Thank you.
Dr. Whitbeck, I am pleased to present the Bryan Collegiate Class of 2018. The academic advisors and I have examined the records of these candidates, and we have found that each has completed the necessary requirements set forth by the Bryan Independent School District and are eligible to participate in these commencement exercises. Additionally, I am pleased to announce that we have 14 students who have completed the required course of study and are candidates for their associate's degrees also at Blaine College.
Thank you, Mr. Roberts. And good job, by the way, on the first year as principal. Way to go. As superintendent of the Bryan Independent School District, it is my pleasure to certify that these assembled students from Bryan Collegiate High School are eligible for these commencement exercises. Congratulations, graduates. As your superintendent, I wanted to take just one moment to share one message with you. I've asked for two of my staff members to show a visual here, and they'll spread out. Because, you know, superintendents used to be teachers, too, believe it or not. And sometimes it's easier to understand a message when you can actually see what we're talking about. But first, I want to share with you that 85% of Americans have completed, by age 26, either a high school diploma or a GED. 26% of Americans declare that they have completed an associate's degree or 2 years of college. Think about where you are already at your age. You're not just there, you are ahead of the game. And this is so, so exciting for this particular group, and I can't tell you how proud we are. I want you to look at this rope, and I want you to see down by Miss Ibarra, there she is down there. I want you to think of this rope as a life. And in our country, a life expectancy is approximately 80 years. So from birth down on this end until 80, where Ms. Carabine is holding, that is a potential life and where we hope that you will be or beyond. You'll notice where the red ties are. That's about where you're getting ready to go. That's around that 18 to 22 years. And what I want to share with you that I have learned from all my years as being a principal and my years as even being a mom, I'm going to call those years the power years. You think the 4 years you just had were, yes, but the next four will make a difference all the way through. So for example, the courses that you take, the training that you decide to get, the degree that you graduate with will help prepare you for the career choice. That will affect your earning power. That will affect your lifestyle. Oftentimes in these next 4 years, you may meet the person you'll spend the rest of your life with. You will make decisions, decisions that are important for everything ahead. So think clearly, make good decisions, keep your mind healthy, physically, spiritually, emotionally. Keep your body strong. Stay out of any kind of trouble, because sometimes that carries on to close doors for people as they move throughout their path. So our wish for you is you make those next 4 years power years. You already have a leg up. So make them the very best you can be, because our wish for you from Bryan ISD is we want you to have a very long and happy and joyful rope. And we want you to just enjoy it, and we are so, so proud of you. So thank you, graduates, and best of luck to you.
Thank you, Dr. Whitbeck. At this time, we will begin the presentation of the diplomas. Yeah, come on. Carla Alvarez. America Jane McCoy. Alejandra Guadalupe Arias. Rocio Erredondo. Olga Ayub Salinas. Christian Allen Bayano Martinez. Liliana Maribel Barón Martinez. Marianne Scarlett Bayo. Kaylee Ember Bernal. Henry Graham Bedeker. William Joseph Bokelman. Crystal Bonillo Gassine.
Melanie A.D. Cabrera. Zachary Richard Cantu. Caleb Ethan Cobb. Orlando Cruz. Orlando Contreras. Jacob William Collier. Raul Cruz. Alan Randolph Davidson. Benito Diaz. Jasmine Elise Dillard. Lisa Josephine Dillard. Joshua Warren Embry. Maribel Escorza. Cassandra Flores. Juan Manuel Fonseca Rodriguez. Jessica Hope Goodman. Dakia Ashley Green. Suzette Margarita Guajardo. Arthur Gutierrez Jr. Jacob Ryan Gutierrez. Destiny Aaliyah Harris. Fatima Guadalupe Henriquez. Alyssa Paula Hernandez. Daniel Alex Hernandez. Jonathan Michael Hernandez. Jonathan Hernandez. Samantha Hernandez. Chloe Ann Hunt. Samantha K. Hunt. Naomi Grace Kessler. Rohel Ahmed Khan. Sitlali Guadalupe Lara Rivera. Miranda Elizabeth Lawrence.
Kieran Mahmood. Colton Scott Merith. Angel Parker Martinez Valesco. Alexis Messino Campos. Hira Uriel Mesa. Marissa Nancy Motes. Milton Mark Molina Hernandez. Abigail Bethany Mosley. Josefina Elizabeth Nava Rios. Wyatt Thomas Nunn. Miguel Ocampa Villanueva. Selena Ortega Badillo. Jesus Eduardo Ortiz. Haley Renee Parker. Yanida Pena. Whitney Pratt. Vincent Damian Pruneda. Peyton Giselle Ramirez. Antonio Annette Renfro. Michelle Guadalupe Rico Ortega. Seth Luis Ring. Keenan Daryl Linder Rogers. Diego Ruiz. Maria Elizabeth Sanchez. Kina Taniel Smallwood. Micah Todd Smith. Alexandria Michelle Sylvester. Isabel Tirado Hernandez. Skylar Brooke Tudaro. Kimberly Jeanette Zunan. Alexis Vasquez. Mary Elizabeth Wagnon. Kyra Zana Leanne Weathersby. Jasmine Destiny Zavala. Lady Laura Zermano Romitinez. Eddie Zuniga Sanchez.
We're waiting on Eddie. There he is. Graduates, please stand and remain standing in your row. At this time, please move your tassel. Congratulations, class of 2018.